Welcome to CivilNet. We have a very special guest in our studio today. Her name is Suman Keshari. She's from Delhi, India, and she is here writing a book about the Armenian genocide in Hindi. Suman, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you, Maria.
It's not very often that we have guests from the east of Armenia, from India, and you're here researching for a book that you're writing about the Armenian genocide, as I said,
yes.
In Hindi. And an interesting piece of information that I learned today, that Hindi is the third most spoken language in the world. It's incredible. But the more incredible part of the story is why you decided to come to Armenia, and this is your first visit, and to do this, to embark on this journey about the Armenian genocide.
Actually, I was not much knowing about this place before 2012, when my husband, Professor Purushottam Agrawal, who was then member of the Union Public Service Commission, he had come here and he saw this place and he was really, you know, very much, he got interested into the place and the subject, and he wrote a book. It is called Hindi Sarai, Astrakhan Via Yerevan. Hindi Sarai is a place, it was a place for traders in Russia, Astrakhan. And he, after Yerevan, he went to Astrakhan. Actually, he wanted to go to Astrakhan. Then he came to Armenia, and then he, of course, he knew about Charens. I had also heard the name of Charens. Okay. But when he really saw his museum, he came, got to know about him, he got to know about Marxists and Cis, and Esmiazin, and Garni and Gedart. He was really deeply interested, and he wrote a book. He calls it Travelogue and Thought Log.
A travelogue and
a thought log, okay. Because lots of thought has been put into that book. It's not only a travelogue, but a lot about Armenian history, a lot about Armenian religion, then about other things, then Turkey, then genocide, not Ottoman Empire, and then genocide. And then, you know, he told me that you must go to Armenia and do some work. I took voluntary, I was in government, I was a director in Ministry of Home Affairs, and in 2013 I took voluntary retirement. And because I'm a poet, I started writing poems and got interested in Armenia. And I met Mane. Mm-hmm. She's a student of Jawaharlal Nehru University, where my husband used to teach earlier. And I am a student of Jawaharlal Nehru University. Mm-hmm. So I met Mane, and you know, to know about a place where so, you know, such a huge number of, I think 150 millions or something. How many millions people were killed?
Nearly 1.5 million.
1.5 millions, yeah. 1.5 million people were killed in a very short span of time. Mm. And, you know, when I heard that on 24th April 1915, initially the intellectuals were killed.
Right.
You know, they were targeted. At the initial state, I am an intellectual. I belong to a family of intellectuals. And I was deeply, you know,
moved by the stories.
Moved, yeah. Rather terrified also. It's moving, it terrifies you, because this is the time when there is a lot of violence in the, you know, environment. And I belong to a country where Mahatma Gandhi, you know, he was born, and Charens was deeply interested, and he was influenced by Mahatma. Mm-hmm. So all these things really, you know, I when I came to Armenia, I never felt that I have come here for the first time, though I am here for the first time. But I feel that this is a place, I am related with this place, some kind of relations there.
You know, Suman, it's very interesting that you say that. You know, living in Armenia, we have also met many Indians. We have a lot of Indian students who study here at Yerevan State University. And, you know, with the diplomatic mission, we've met, you know, Indian diplomats. There seems to be an affinity between Armenians and Indians. There's a lot of similarities in the language, in the culture even. And it seems that Armenians and Indians, whenever they meet, they seem to to find a common ground. it's a fascinating thing. And there's, you know, for our viewers who don't know, there's a long history between Armenia and India. A lot of Armenians, you know, starting 2,000 years ago, but certainly in the 16th, 17th, 18th centuries. What do the Indians of India know about the Armenians in general?
Normally not much. When I spoke to people in India, not many people, rather I would say very few people knew about this world called Armenia. Even they didn't know even the word, Armenia and Yerevan. But I'm happy that my husband wrote a book about Yerevan and Armenia and Astrakhan. So not many people know about this. In Kolkata, there is a colony. In Chennai, in Mumbai, there are people. And fortunately, we are even, you must be knowing Keith and Garabian.
Yes, Keith Garabian, of course.
I'm translating Keith.
Oh, really? He's a Canadian, Armenian, Indian author from Canada. Yes, of course.
His mother was Armenian.
Yes. No, his father.
His father was Armenian and his mother was Anglo-Indian.
That's right.
Yeah, and I'm translating Keith because he's written in English. So it's easy for me to translate that, you know, on my own. And in spite of this, in spite of the fact that in 16th century, in 17th century, during Akbar period, and we have written, you know, history about that, traders from Armenia came to India and a lot of, you know, people from India also came to Armenia, and there was a lot of trade, you know, it's kind of a booming trade with on this route. But still, you know, it's very unfortunate that not many people know about Armenia.
Well, I'm sure that with your efforts and your husband's efforts, now many people will know, especially that you're writing in Hindi.
I would really love to. That's why I'm writing in Hindi. Yeah.
So tell me, where have you been in Armenia so far? You mentioned a few places like Etchmiadzin and Garni Kemart.
Yeah, I'll just, because, you know, the words are a bit, you know, different from our language, so. I'll tell you that I have been to Garni,
the pagan temple there.
Yeah, the Kedar Monastery, and Zvartnots,
yes. Yeah, so. It's beautiful,
wonderful place. And I am interested because there's a monument of phallus that we call it Ling, Shiva Ling. It's like that. And it's there. Yeah. I was really, rather excited to see that. Because whenever I never thought that I'll get a, you know, phallus or a Shiva Linga sort of a monument here. But it is there. And then, again, I think there is a kind of a, you know, there must have been some kind of a relations within these civilizations. And when I am today, I saw the ornaments,
the jewelry,
right. No? And then I found that most of the jewelries were designed. There's a similar design in India, we have the same, and here also I saw the same.
Yeah, well, Armenians have also a long history in jewelry making,
You go. Yeah.
Okay, so when do you plan on publishing the book? I mean, is it a historical narrative or is it going to be through stories and letters?
It's not exactly a historical narrative. Not exactly. I'm a person from literature. I'm a poet and a writer. So I want to see the times, the period, that 1915 and before that and after that, through the eyes of the writers. How do they see this period? How do they write about this period? What they think? And of course, there would be some history.
Sure.
There would be some history. And then we are even, you know, interviewing people. And so it's a kind of, there would be poems in Hindi, charins and sevak.
Parur Sevak,
and
through the words and works of Armenian poets.
Yeah,
from an Indian poet.
You're from an Indian poet.
Well, I think that's lovely. So thank you so much for coming, taking the time to come to our studio and talk about this in this most important year for Armenians, it's the 100th anniversary of the Armenian genocide of 1915. So the more people know about it and the more that we can talk to people so that history isn't repeated, so people understand that atrocities of the past must be condemned. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I'd like to remind our viewers that my guest was Indian poetess and writer Suman Keshari from India. Stay with CivilNet.